Kylie Oye. Moving forward in our series of videos on HackSite recovery, you're now ready to assess the damage. This video is tailored to those who received a message that their site was infected with malware, and who have a fairly technical background in viewing source code and running commands in the terminal. To help and to share his expertise in fighting malware, I'm joined with an engineer on Google's Safe Browsing team, Lucas Ballard.
Hi, Miley.
Thanks for offering to help. Thus far, we've heard an overview of hacking and confirmed that our site was compromised to serve malware. Now we're ready to assess the damage. But before we go any further, can you explain what exactly is malware?
Sure. Malware is a general term for malicious software that is designed to harm a computer or network. Malware includes things like viruses, worms, spyware, keyloggers, and Trojan horses. To protect everyone on the web from malicious software, the Google Safe Browsing team runs internet-wide scanners to find harmful pages. Our automatic scanners determine whether pages are infected by detecting malicious content. The reputation of the webmaster is not a factor in the process. If your site was infected with malware, you're not alone. We find about 10,000 newly infected websites each day.
That's helpful to know. Can you also provide a concrete example of what it means for a site to be infected with malware?
Of course. Whenever legitimate sites are labeled as infected with malware, it's because Google has determined that when a user visits these sites, their browser will automatically visit another site that will attack the browser. Typically, the browser visits this attack site because the legitimate site, or one of the resources included by the legitimate site, has been modified to include content from the attack site. We alert users to malware pages because when a user visits the infected page, content from an attack site will exploit a vulnerability in the user's browser. Once the exploit is successful, malicious software is automatically loaded onto the user's computer without their knowledge. The malicious software may be spyware to gather users' banking credentials, or malware that uses the infected computer to send spam. With the user's computer compromised, the hacker has added another node in their malware network, which can be used to attack other computers or websites.
Your example really demonstrates how malware spreads like an infectious disease. Please explain how site owners can learn if their site is infected with malware, or if their site was involved in infecting others.
Okay. Google Safe Browsing publicly displays this information to all users, regardless of whether you're the verified site owner. Let's go to our laptop and navigate to Google Safe Browsing diagnostic page. It's at www.google.com/safebrowsing/diagnostic?site=, and then your site. For example, I might add googleonlinesecurity.blogspot.com. Here you can see the current status of your site with regard to whether users can safely browse your pages. My team runs the scanners responsible for generating this data. Thankfully, our online security blog is safe. Let's take a look at a site infected with malware to show more information on what each of you might be seeing. The type of information you'll see on the Safe Browsing Diagnostic page is the site's current status, meaning is the site likely to be safe or is it suspicious and dangerous for users? Sites infected with malware are obviously listed as suspicious. Below that, in what happened when Google visited this site, we display more detailed information. For example, you can see which attack sites were being included from your site. You can also view information about the attack site itself. Again, the attack site is used to actually host the malware to infect users and check if your site was included in a larger malware network. Clicking on the attack site or network brings you to more information within Safe Browsing. The last bit of information on this page shows whether your site was used as an intermediary to infect other sites or to host malware.
Thanks, Lucas. Moving forward, now that we understand malware, can you explain how to safely investigate the damage on our own site?
Good question. I'm glad you asked. Before you view pages, delete files, or modify your site, let's start with several tips for investigating malware. First, please do not use your browser to open an infected web page. As mentioned earlier, malware often spreads by exploiting browser vulnerabilities. Opening an infected web page in your browser is just asking for trouble. Second, it's very helpful when investigating malicious code to have server access. Because some malware is configured so that it only displays based on the user agent, cookies, referrer, time of day, operating system, or browser version, it's good to see the actual source code of the page for better understanding of its content and behavior. Third, there are a couple useful tools for conducting diagnostic HTTP requests, or page fetches, for assessing the damage to your site. Because hackers often configure redirects from legitimate sites to attack sites, just looking at a page's source code may be insufficient for detecting redirects. You'll need to actually fetch the page. Two helpful, often freely available tools are wget and curl. Both wget and curl make HTTP requests, and they can be configured to include referrer, user agent, or browser information. These capabilities are helpful to reveal some of the sophisticated techniques hackers use to avoid detection. For example, the hacker may configure the site to only redirect to malicious content when the URL is requested from a search result page, meaning that if the user searched on google.com, their request for a page will include a Google referrer. By only serving malicious content to users with a Google referrer, the hacker has targeted more real people and can better prevent detection from webmasters and malware scanners. Searching for wget and curl should return resources further explaining their usage.
To recap what you've covered, when investigating malware on our site, 1. Don't open the page in a browser. 2. View the source code of the page on the file system. And 3. Look for redirects and check source code through wget or curl. If those are tips for safely investigating malware, how should we start actually assessing the damage?
Well, we already visited the Safe Browsing Diagnostic page to gain a high-level view of how malware affected our site. The next place to look is the malware section of Webmaster Tools.
As a verified owner of my site, I'll log into Webmaster Tools. Select my site, Diagnostics, then Malware. Lucas, can you tell us more about the information your team displays on this page?
Definitely. The malware page is comprised of two buttons at the top, Download Table and Requester Review. You'll use the Requester Review button once your site is malware-free. Before we get there, though, we'll need to assess the damage. The table on this page shows a sample of the infected URLs from your site, the type of infection our scanners recognize, and the most recent date it was detected. Clicking on the URL leads to the malware details page with specific action items. Some URL examples lack an infection type. While our scanners detected the URL as malicious, we were unable to identify the specific behavior. For the others, I'll give an in-depth explanation of each infection type in an individual video. After each sample URL in Webmaster Tools is investigated, the last action of the step is to more generally assess the damage to your site.
Yes, file system damage assessment is the last video to watch in this step. File system damage assessment helps you compile a list of files that were modified or added by the cybercriminal to aid in cleanup in the steps ahead. Thanks, Lucas. Everyone, for each malware type on your site, please check out Lucas's corresponding videos on topics like server configuration, SQL injection, and error template. Once you've investigated the damage for all malware types on your site, make sure to perform a general file system assessment. When these actions are completed, advance to the next step. Identify the vulnerability. We're getting closer to recovery. Keep up the great work.